On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Hello, my dear listeners, may God bless all those who believe, because the ones who believe are courageous, and only the courageous are the ones who believe, and the courageous, they believe. And God, in His endless mercy and compassion and righteousness and love, He wants to bring and to call all the courageous to conquer those that are lost, that have no hope, people that find themselves completely surrendered to their problems, and they are searching for salvation, because there are those out there that they are thirsty, they are hungry and thirsty for justice. And this is God's message for you. And I'm going to address once again the message that we have been speaking in the church, that talks about God's will, that talks about that word in which Jesus said that no one can serve two masters. Either you serve God or you serve the devil, or you serve justice or you serve injustice. And all of us, we are subjected to this. And who do you serve? If I serve sin, then I will reap the fruits of sin. If I follow, if I obey justice, then I will reap the fruits of riches. And God is the one who gives the offer, and we are the ones who take. Let us hear this word, and we will be right back. Who has not asked themselves this question? Why my prayers are not yet answered? Or why did God allow something bad to happen to me? Or why can't I reach God's promises? The answer is very simple to this than you can imagine. Pay attention. God is only responsible to those that serve Him. Keep this. If you do not serve God, He is not responsible to what happens in your life. The Lord Jesus, He said about this, like this: no one can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will be loyal to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. That's the reason. What happens is that many times people are serving other lords and not God. And this Lord in which they are serving are the ones that is responsible for the quality of life
that you have.
Let us understand this better to make an illustration. How can I serve God if I don't see Him? He is Spirit. Jesus, He is the Word. Jesus is the Word. That in John chapter 1 says that the Word became flesh. The Word was God and came into flesh. So Jesus is the Word. And the Word is the Lord Jesus. So when I obey the Word of the Lord Jesus, I am serving Him. If I do not obey His Word, then I do not serve Him. And it's simple as it is. So if I serve the Lord, then He is my God, He is my Father. But on the other hand, I also have another Lord, which is Mammon. Mammon means anything that I appreciate, anything that I serve, or anyone that I serve, that automatically turns to be my master. And that's why so many have been serving other things and not God. And that is the reason why they have been failing in their life. Many have served or lived for the money, which is the world's greatest God. And all their energy and effort is in search on making money. There are people who even give their own lives for money. There are others that have been marrying people just for the money. They only want to inherit that money that belongs to that such person. There are people who make their career their master, their God, and they want that promotion, they want that position. And the list goes on. And you see family taking God's place, traveling taking God's place, glamour of this world, everything is a Mammon in your life. And if you have been living your life to serve these things, know this. These things are your master. So then, you cannot serve Mammon, and then you pray to God for help. He is not your Lord, so you have no means to call upon Him. So He is not responsible for what happens in your life. And that's the reason why so many prayers that you make are not answered, many bad things have been happening, and God's promises have not been fulfilled in your life. So the question is, who are you serving?
So who have you been serving? Who am I serving? So when people, they serve the living God, when they serve the God of the Bible, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Israel, the Lord Jesus Christ, so then they have the right and privilege to eat of the best of the land. But if people do not serve God, they are serving their religion. You know it. How many people they have heard? I've heard people saying, Bishop, look, you have your religion, I have mine. I have heard people saying this many times to me. Whenever I'll talk about Jesus to them, they said, I was born Catholic, I am Catholic, and I will die Catholic. All right. So, continue. It's your life. You choose who you please. So they serve Catholic Church or the denomination that they have. You can serve any church, any religion. So you have a life according to the master of your life. And this is very powerful. And the best part of this is that God gave us the privilege to make a choice, to choose which master we want to follow. So no one can impede me from serving the Lord. So if you don't want to serve the Lord, God can do nothing. He can do nothing. There is nothing that He can do if you
want to serve evil. There is nothing that God is going to respect our free will. And that is why, my dear listener, you are going to read, we're going to read in a few minutes this verse, but I want you to understand when God tells His people, the people of Israel in the beginning, the people that were slaves, the people that were taken from slavery, and they took possession of a land that flowed with milk and honey. And then these people that met the God of Abraham, the God of Israel, the God of Gideon, the God of Moses, the God of Joshua, the God who is the Lord of hosts. But even though these people, they got corrupted. Matter of fact, they turned their back to God and began to serve Mammon. And of course, they were desolated, they lost, they began to be removed from the land in which was theirs because they disobeyed God's voice. And this is the scripture I want to read for you. Thus says the Lord of hosts. This is very important. Pay attention. Thus says the Lord of hosts. He says, the Lord of hosts says, return to me, says the Lord of hosts. And I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. So he says, the Lord of the hosts, the only living God, the people in that time, they knew what was an army. There was war, constant war, all the time. But God, He identified Himself to these people that lived in war, that lived in building themselves wall in order to keep themselves protected and safe. But they couldn't find refuge. They had to keep fighting. They had to keep maintaining themselves, always watchful, 24/7, in order for them not to be caught by surprise. So for these people that were accustomed to fight, accustomed into war and battle, because you fight every day. Every day you must fight for your daily bread. Every day you must fight in order to have information, education, for you to have a degree, to fight for your life in order to survive. Every day we face our wars, our battles. And God allowed these wars to take place so that we can turn to His Word, so that we may understand His purpose in our life. Because He says like this, thus says the Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts is the Lord of the Master. He is the Lord of victory. He's the one who can guarantee your victory. He's the one who can guarantee that He will prevail what may come. And when you prevail in faith, you prevail in life, when you prevail and you are saved as well. So to prevail in your salvation, the salvation of your soul. So, thus says the Lord of hosts, the one who has all the armor, who has all power, who has all authority to grant victory to those who call upon Him. But of course, if they do not serve the Lord of hosts, how can they be victorious? If they do not serve the Lord of hosts, how can they want to survive serving Mammon, who is weak and defeated? Is it clear? You who are listening to me right now, I'm speaking to you. I'm speaking to you. You can even be inside of the church. You may know the Bible. You may know the Bible from cover to cover. But if you do not practice this word, if you do not turn to God, forget all your knowledge. What is the point of being a good doctor, but if he's sick? How can he treat people? How can he operate on people? How can a teacher teach if he does not know the subject, if he does not know what he's talking about? So, my dear listener, the Lord of hosts wants to give you victory. And that's why he identifies himself as the Lord of hosts, the Lord of victory, the one who wants to be in charge. Imagine the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel being defeated or to lose a battle. Of course not. He knows it all. So this Lord wants and inviting those who are weak, those who are serving Naaman, and he's saying, come to my side, turn to me, and you are going to win. It's what he says, return to me, turn to me, and I will turn to you. This is what the Lord of hosts says in this verse that we are reading, Zechariah chapter 1. Zechariah 1. We see three times, says the Lord of hosts in the beginning, says the Lord of hosts in between, and says the Lord of hosts in the end. So it starts with the Lord of hosts, in the middle of the sentence says the Lord of hosts, and ending or closing what he's saying, he identifies himself as the Lord of hosts. Do we need this? Does he need to make it so clear that he is the Lord of hosts? He could have said it only once. And he could have said it once, return to me and I'll return to you, and that's it. But he made sure to note that says the Lord of hosts three times, so that you, my dear listener, who are failing in life, you that have your faith is weak, you that have your faith upside down, you that are having the knowledge of the Word of God, like, for example, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not be in want, but everything is missing, everything is lacking in your life. You confess the Lord is my shepherd, but I shall not be in want, but everything you lack everything in your house. Your fridge is empty, your financial life is broke, you are unhappy in your love life, you are sick. So then how can he be the Lord? He's not the Lord. So my dear listener, how come this is going on? Because you know the Bible very well, but you have not been practiced what is written, because the Lord has not been your shepherd. He's not guiding you. In fact, God has been guiding. If you know what is written in the Bible, but you're doing what is wrong, it's not going to work. You are trying to serve God in your own way. There is no way to serve God in their way. A person who are placing themselves as a servant of Jesus, they must serve Him the way that He requires. If you serve the devil, whoever serves the devil, if they don't serve the devil that he wants and the way he likes, the devil does something to them. The devil breaks something. He destroys things in their life. Simply because whoever is following them, they must do as is required. My dear listener, look, I want to give myself as an example. I always talk about the Lord of hosts, and I speak about this for about 40 some years, and not even when the church was opened yet, but for 54 years that I have been following the Lord of hosts. If God was not with me, do you think I would be here? The spirits of evil, of the entities, of hell, wouldn't destroy me already or taken me down? But how come am I still standing? Although all the jealousy, despite of all the persecution, of all the things they do against my name, against all the accusations of all hell that we have faced, I'm still here, I'm still standing. I am still standing. I am still here. And I'm here alive. so that everyone can see me. And why? Why am I here? Why am I still well? And you know why? Because I serve the Lord of hosts. I serve the Lord of hosts as it is written. I serve the Lord of hosts. That is why I challenge all the gods of this world. I challenge all hell, the devil and all his hell, simply because the Lord of hosts, if he is fake, then I am doomed. But if he exists, I will succeed, and that is my faith, and that's the faith of the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God. And whoever believes like this will join me, and who doesn't believe, go out. May God bless all of you.
So Moses sang, and the Israelites to the Lord, for what God has done in the land of Pharaoh. Because our Lord gloriously He overcame. He opened the Red Sea and Israel passed. For this is our God, He is the God of our Father. So now I will exalt His name, He is the Lord. Every drop of the sea understood that in front of the people of God was the great man of war, the God of today. All the soldiers that Pharaoh sent, they drowned under the sea. The Red Sea with my dry feet I was able to pass. For the Lord is my strength and my praise. He's given me His salvation. Who is like You?
Adopted, and I didn't understand my adoptive parents. I didn't understand where they were coming from. You know, I wanted to know who my real mom is and what she did and who she was. And my parents always told me that she wasn't a good person. You don't need to be around her. So I started to rebel. I was hanging out in the streets, hanging out with wrong friends, you know, smoking. I found my real mom and I ended up living with her. And to find out it wasn't the way I needed to be. And there was other times where she did pull me into certain other lifestyle with drug dealers and stuff like that. 3 years ago, she had introduced me to this guy and said, you know, if you need your phone bill paid, if you need, you want a real man, this is a man that could take care of you. He was no good. She only did that for him to be around so she can get her crack. And one time, one of her friends ratted her out. And one night, I just came home from work. And I come in the house and I just changed my clothes and there's a whole bunch of police in the house. So everybody had to go to jail. I just started to break down and cry. I was like, why did I do this to myself? Why did I get myself in this place? Why did I have to go so hard to go nowhere, you know? I couldn't change the situation because that person didn't want it to change. It was devastating. So I read the paper and it was like, do you feel like you have bad luck, depression, bad spirits? And I was like, wow, okay, maybe I'll go on a Friday to the church. I don't like how my life is going. I feel very depressed, so I'll give it a try. I definitely saw the change in me, and I saw where I was and where I could be. You don't have to choose the negative life. You don't have to choose smoking. You don't have to party. You don't have to drink to feel good, to feel happy, to think that you're gonna overcome your depression, your anxiety, whatever you go through. That's not the way. Walking through the doors of University Church gave me a way to build my faith. You know, use what God gave us to use, you know? There is a God out there. There's a God, and he's loving, he's caring, and he's here to change your life, help you be the person that you are designed and to be.
What an honor to know that I'm your child. You are so infinite and holy. Whenever I am alone, you are there beside me. A father such as you, so great, eternal. How precious is your presence within me. Words cannot express just how I feel. I know that when I'm standing in your presence, hope reaches out to you in heaven. Hear what I proclaim in faith to you. What an honor to have you live within me. What a to call upon you and receive an honor, such an honor. What a pleasure to embrace you, our dear soul. I found you, I'll follow where you go. I love you. Precious is your presence within me. Words cannot express just how I feel. I know that when I'm standing in your presence, hope reaches out.